So, good morning. A journey through time. It sounds a bit like a movie title, right? So, in this cinema setting, I would like to mix it up a bit and have a theme. So, I'd like to tell you a story, take you on a journey through time and space, traveling without moving, and start at the beginning of time, or maybe even a bit earlier, at least from a developer's point of view. So, it all starts in 1990. Total Recall, Yippee-ki-yay, bleep, sorry, don't want to be demonetized. And Back to the Future 3 already. So, we are at a time that Back to the Future had already had two sequels. It is also the time that I started my studies in information technology. Hi, I'm Ivo Wolting. I'm a principal expert at Ordina and a codesmith. I was hoping to show you a very fancy new t-shirt, but wasn't ready yet. And I'm an editor of the Java magazine, so if you want to write articles, find me. I'm always happy to get more ideas. And I like to write, and this is my Twitter handle. As you can see, I've been writing quite a bit about Java the last couple of years. And one of the reasons I do this is that I have been working on Java 1.8 for almost all this time. How many have done that too? Yeah, was expecting something like that. So, how do you stay current? Well, that's two ways in my opinion. Teach about it or write about it. Or both. And I've done both. And who knows this small sentence here? Yeah. Do you miss them? Yeah. The Java posse. Java. I'm not going to sing it. Sorry. So, let's start a journey for real. 1991. This is the year that Silence of the Lambs, tell me his name, Doctor. Delicatessa, who knows that movie? I've seen this movie in a sports hall, kind of small thing on rickety chairs in France. And I've cried from laughing from about the first 5 minutes to the last minute. So, watch this one. I'll be back. This is also the year that the Green Team started working on a project that later became Java. Patrick Norton, Mike Sheridan, and the father of Java, James Gosling. And not so fun fact, Patrick Norton was also sentenced for a sex crime with a minor. So, not all the fathers are created equal. Google him, it's not all that nice. Mike Sheridan has dropped off the face of the earth, or at least the bias that I could find about him was always a technical guy at a company and with a reference to he worked on Java. They were called the Green Team and they were starting on a project for set-top boxes and mobile devices because they thought this was going to be the next big thing. But as TVs were looking kind of like this in 1991, they were a bit ahead of their time. But they did make a working model. It was called Star 7. And if you search this or Google this with James Gosling in the same search, then you'll find a very nice YouTube video where he explains it himself, a very young James Gosling. And yes, it was handheld. That's his hand. And it had a touchscreen and everything. And they butchered all kinds of other tools to make this happen. And this was also the first appearance of the Duke. The Duke actually guided you through this system. The way back button. I don't know if the way back machine comes from there. I'd like to think so, but it isn't. And now the journey really begins. Because the logos have changed quite a bit, right? Oh, yeah, I have to do this, sorry. I hope you, because I love being here and and I always forget, and this is just, can you all just make this really, yay, woo! Oh God, thanks. Thank you for being patient. So, I have a question for you. What was Java called first? And I want like to see a show of hands. Who thinks it's Oak? Quite a few, but almost all of you. And who, oh, shit! It was Green Talk. But don't be angry. Oak, it was longer. And it was only called Green Talk for a very short time. But it was dubbed by James Gosling himself, and he even had an extension for it and everything. I don't know why it was renamed, but Oak was renamed because of copyright stuff, and there was already a company. And then it became Java. Also, by the way, it was voted upon, but it was also dubbed first by James Gosling. So. And it was called Oak for a long time because of the oak outside of the office window of James Gosling. And I'm not a nerd at all, but I touched that oak. But I deny everything. So, 1996, the year of Independence Day, The Rock, and Alien 3. And if it's a Mission Impossible, why do you do it then? Okay. Just a question. But this is also the year that Sun Microsystems first published the Java Development Kit 1.0. So the first real release of Java. It was also the year that Java 1 was held for the first time. And Java applets were the thing. Writing applications for in the browser, for like Netscape. Who still knows Netscape? And the first really stable version was 1.0.2, which was dubbed Java 1. Did I? Ah, so I went too fast. Now we are spending a bit of time. We're traveling 1996 to 2004. 1996, well, we had Firefly, and in my humble opinion, the best science fiction series ever created. Who agrees? Only a few hands. But in my humble opinion, it was. And sadly, and to my great disappointment, also cancelled in one season. And the story wasn't finished. Titanic, Man in Black. I'll let you look at my, if you don't like this talk, I'll let you look at my light later. And The Phantom Menace. Also the year that Java 1.1 came out. Inner classes. Yes, they were new. Can I point? Yeah, it does work. And Yeah. Do I have to say much about this? Inner classes, not all that fancy, right? But they were. This one was big. Java Beans. Because almost every framework ever created used and abused this. Getters, setters, default constructors, and mutability. It was hot and very... So remember this one, it's important. JDBC. JDBC was introduced so we could connect to a database. Yay! Who programmed JDBC raw? Did you like the checked exceptions? Yes. Are you wondering? Yes. Oh, okay. Well, there were many of them. But nowadays we have JPA, all kinds of wrappers, ORMs, and Spring Data, of course. But at that time, this was a big thing. Remote method invocation. I'm so happy it's gone. And Swing, native Java, in AWT. Do I say it good or correct? AWT, yeah, AWT. Was not native Java, so you had to have a native compilation for every platform. And this was fully Java. So, cool thing. And the JIT compiler was introduced in Java 1.2 for the first time. And this was also a very big thing, and a just-in-time compiler. Best of both worlds. Yeah? So we compile and have interpretation during runtime, optimization on the fly. So it was introduced quite early in Java. Really cool. And Joshua Bloch came along and wrote the collections framework. Where do we know Joshua Bloch more from? Effective Java, right? You've all read that book, I guess.
Which one?
I don't know when you started, but if you haven't read that book, please do. Or at least have it as a piece of, of, yeah, I got this book. It's really good. So, collections. And in Java 1.3, the hotspot JVM was introduced. So this was with the JIT compiler, class loading, what else? I'll have a look. And two VM, the client and the server VM. Client was optimized for startup. And the server had more JIT effort. So startup was a bit slower, but there was more JIT effort in and just in time in the server side. And of course, supporting libraries. If you want to know all the flags you can use to tune your VM, or almost all of them, this is just a simple command for it. So make a picture. And of course we missed Perl so much that we wanted to have the regex back. Who still uses regex a lot? I do. It's still very powerful. So it came back, or was introduced. Non-blocking I/O was also introduced, and the logging API. Well, it's not all that fancy, but we use it a lot. Java Web Start, who still knows it? It was really powerful because Java Web Start was through the browser. You could create a new release. No CDs had to be printed or burned. No distribution, just through the internet. It was deprecated in Java 9 and removed in Java 11. So let's move on. 2004, Harry Potter. Yeah, I know, I love it, but and iRobot. Good movies, these were the real blockbusters. Shrek. Also the year that Java 1.5 came out. Who knows this book? Java, the good parts, right? This was the year of this was the version that I actually still from Sun this at that time. I certified myself in. I was working in Java 1.4 at that time, and Java 1.3 was also very common. So casting a lot, no autoboxing. It was called Java 5 Tiger. And this was the first time that versioning became a bit fuzzy. Is it 1.5 or is it Java 5? Well, a bit of both. And that versioning conflict stayed with us for a very long time. 8 years between the first version and this version. So two years per version, kind of. So not all that long, right? But it wasn't sure. And 75% of all programmers at this time used Java as their primary language. So that is quite awesome. And at Java 1, for the first time, open source discussions were started. So should Java be open source? And 1.5 billion devices were using Java. So just a number, but quite huge number. Generics were introduced. Note that we still had to do this in Java 5, before and after the equal sign. Luckily, we had good IDEs, right? Code completion. From a developer's point of view, this was a huge thing. And we still use it a lot. Typed arrays. Well, these are a few other things. Static imports. I never use it for a system out, but I have an example. And I wanted to put multiple examples in one code snippet. The var args, I've got two. The var args can only be added to the as the last item in the list. And the enhanced for loop. Most of us can't even remember that there is another one. Right? But it was introduced in Java 5. Autoboxing, another one of those things that are so common now that we can't even remember that we had to do this ourselves before Java 5. Because this was real. We had to do this. And the int value, if we wanted to have the primitive. Autoboxing was huge. Enums were introduced. So before Java 5, we didn't have them. And annotations, metadata. This is actually not a Java 5 example. This is a very current Spring, I think, example somewhere, yeah. But it also shows that we can have quite a bit of metadata on classes, but so compile time and runtime metadata, very powerful stuff. We use all the time and Spring is built on it. Magic. And Spring became skinnable. Yeah, you have to look at it, but the boxes do look different. I didn't make an example, sorry. So, quite a few things in Java 1.5. It was a really big update. And then Java 2005 came along. Serenity, the revenge of Josh Whedon for canceling his Firefly series. Sorry, it's still the best. And so he made a movie with the same cast and finished the story. And it's still one of the, well, go watch it, but watch the series first, only 14 episodes, and then watch this one. You won't be disappointed. This one became later like Castle in the series Castle. And there was a one episode where it was Halloween party. And he actually, in this Castle series, he had on his red suit. And I love that. And there was also a moment that he spoke Chinese. And he said, yeah, checkered past or something, he said. And it was also a reference to this series. 2006 to 2008. I'm not trying to distract you at all. But this was the time that the Duke became officially open sourced. And so we can use it any way we like, as long as we keep it the Duke, right? GNU, public license. So let's just enjoy this moment. Also, Predator versus Alien. Where is Wally? Did we find him? Pirates of the Caribbean. Yeah, it's going to continue. 5.5 billion devices at this time were running Java. So growing fast, 6 million Java developers worldwide. So not bad. And Java SE6 was also released. No cool features were in there, but it was a huge performance release. This was actually the first release where Java became, including the JIT compiler, I must say, faster than C with their ahead of time compiler. In many cases, not always, but still very impressive. Just a question, who's more a Star Wars fan? You can be both or none. Star Wars? All right, Star Trek? I'm a bit of both. I can't choose. Sorry. In 2009, Avatar came out. Avatar was the first movie that I saw in IMAX 3D, and I was blown away. I thought it was fantastic. Only at the second or third watching, I found out that it was a simple love story. but still, huh? Good movies, and Green Lantern not so much. It was kind of a bust, but it must not have been for Ryan Reynolds himself, because he married the lead female character from that play only years later. But and in 2011 I went to Java 1 for the first time, and it was the first time that it wasn't Sun, so I went to the first Oracle Java 1. Okay. And Minecraft was of course written in Java, and one of the most popular games ever. Maybe the most popular game ever. Generics were improved. We didn't have to do the whole thing there again. I thought it was quite big. Because look at this. I didn't have to really type it, but still. And in Project Coin, all these kinds of things happened, like string in switches. And in 2014, kind of a scary movie about AI. I hope it isn't real. Who's you? Can I trust you? Guardians of the Galaxy, I love that movie. Edge of Tomorrow, also a travel through time. Again and again and again. It's like Groundhog Day, right? And then also the year that Java 1.8 or Java 8 came out. Yeah, this one was really, really big. I think that most of us here in the room have the most experience with Java 1.8. I see nods. Quite a few of them. So many books. Who is still on Java 8? No, who is before Java 8? Who is on an older version? One? Oh God, another one? No. Is there a good reason? Oh, God. Who's already on Java 17? Oh, you lucky bastard. Yeah, I want to be, because lots of cool stuff has happened. But Java 8 still very common. At the time that I started on this talk, I was still on Java 1.8. Now I'm on 11, so improvement. But it took a long time for people to start adapting 11. The datetime API. So this is the time that the date was fixed. If you read my small bio thing. Yeah, local date. It just, finally it was there. There was even a discussion that there was a framework at that time. Oh, what was it called? Yoda time, yeah. But they didn't, in the end they didn't do that, right? Maybe they stole a bit, I don't know. But way better than it was. Actually the get date and stuff, it was really broken because it was based on, if you did the get year, then right now you would get something like 121, because they were counting from the 1900s. Streams, yeah. So we have lots of experience with this, right? All of us. Maybe not with this one, but interfaces were, well, expanded upon. Default methods in interfaces. Start of functional programming kind of thing. Static methods and functional interfaces. So, as functions can be passed as parameters, interfaces can be passed as parameters, you effectively had functions now that you can pass. So this made functions first-class citizens as in every functional language. Very cool stuff. Who of you have written their own functional interfaces? It's quite cool to play with, right? You probably don't have to most of the time. Most of the functional interfaces that we need are already provided. But it's cool to play around with. And completable futures were introduced. Yeah. I've actually almost never worked with this yet. Who has? Cool. Let's talk. Well, I have made, because I've made these example code snippets, I've actually made a whole Git repository from the first version to the last version. And there are actually in the newer versions stuff that I haven't played with around a lot. But I would like to, so if there's an interest in a meetup somewhere to just play around with the cool stuff, let me know. I'll gladly do that. Yeah. Question. Who thinks that Java is older than Python? Ooh, not all that many. Like a third, maybe. Python is older. Quite a bit, actually. Like 5 years older. Guido van Rossum published his first version on Alt Sources in 1991, and his first version 1.0 was in 1994, so at least 1 year before Java came out. And because it was directly open source, it was available from 1991. I actually downloaded my first version on a 14K4 modem in 1995. And yeah, I was, oh God, I'm already 1.5 hours online. That's costing me so much. Yeah, I see lots of young people, but more my age, very young still, then you remember this. Yeah. So who says Java is old? Because Python is often seen as the younger dynamic language, right? But it's actually quite a bit older. So we progressed through time. Deadpool, he actually shot himself because of Green Lantern. I love those crossovers. Every time I watch these kinds of movies, I'm looking for these hidden gems, and I still think that I miss lots of them. But hey, I love them. Also, the period that Java 9 came out, and Java 9 was big and also very controversial, because it introduced modularization, and no developer ever asked for that. Big companies did, and there was a good reason for. But it also broke with backwards compatibility for the first time, and that was of course really big, because Java was really known for its backward compatibility, right? Well, maybe that is one of the reasons that adoption of Java 11 took so long, because all the frameworks first had to go. Because if you were a pioneer at this time, well, you had to do a lot, because actually Maven didn't work with it, Spring didn't work with it. There was so much to do. But it has been fixed. But it also, JCell, of the REPL was introduced. And so it's quite late in Java that a REPL was introduced. The read, eval, print loop. I almost never use it, so I don't know, maybe because I was introduced to Java before it was there, but even for demos, I tend to make small main classes. Who does use this extensively? Who? No hands. Really wanted feature. I didn't expect that. 2018, the end game. We are nearing the end game also. Deadpool 2. I love that they made this kind of Valentine's theme, because then you could take your girlfriend or wife to the movies, and then I didn't know. The fantastic play. Yeah. Maybe you noticed that I'm a Marvel fan. I'll deny everything again, of course. Java 10 was also the version where Oracle pronounced the 6-month release cycle. And it was a big thing, because now you know that every 6 months a new version will come out. You don't know the scope, the full scope, but you do know a new version will come. And that also introduced the incubation and preview features. So developers could get used to all the stuff that is coming. So preview. They could still change it a lot, and it actually happened with the multi-line string, I think, and quite a few other preview features, but you can still, it was already there, and if you put in the preview flag, you could play around with it. And I like that, because, hey, I wrote the article, so I could actually play around with it. And once in every 3 years, an LTS version, long-term support, starting from Java 11. The copy off, yeah, it's the nothing in Java 10 was also mainly a performance thing. Lots of stuff happened on the garbage collector. Every version, by the way, lots of stuff happens there, and updating to new architectures. And it's not really, from a developer's point of view, not all that interesting. So this was the interesting thing for a developer. And this is a hidden feature that many of you might not know about, the shebang. Who also writes shell scripts? Yeah, well, you can use Java as a shell script now. If you put in the correct shebang, this one, this is a shebang. And if you have a one file class with a main, so you cannot do this for a whole modularized multi-class thing, but if you have a one single class application, you can do this and make it executable and run it as a shell script. Nice to know. Yes, it worked. Works. I love these gems because I didn't know about this, and I don't know if I'll ever use it, but still. The not. Why not use the exclamation mark? But this is also the version. Oh, this was the LTS version, right? So long-term support. For big companies, this means something. I don't know if it actually should, unless you have an open Oracle OpenJDK contract service support kind of thing. Otherwise, it means nothing. And if it does, please tell me how. I think I'll have to really get into this, because LTS, it means so much, but it doesn't mean anything, I think. So it took a really long time for companies and us to start adopting this version. But now most of us, I think, are getting there. Dare I say this? Who's on 11? At least a half, maybe. That's good. So the start of the elimination of Apache string utils, maybe. So some string util methods. And the Java EE modules for JUXB were removed from the standard edition, because it was actually an EE feature, the extended edition. HTTP client was introduced. Yeah. And Spring wrote a wrap around that, of course. Is this a viable statement? Ooh, a statement. Is this a viable statement? Who says yes? I see one. I see two. Oh, not a lot. Why not?
Your quotes are wrong.
Okay. Assume that the quotes are right. Is it then a viable statement? Ooh, you're very hot. It is a valid. Okay, maybe that came out. Sorry. Don't demonetize me. I didn't mean it. Sorry. It is a valid statement because var is not a keyword. So you could do this. you can do this. It's not advisable, but this is done because of the backwards compatibility. Because you could have a variable already called var. Because, hey, naming. Java naming. You like long words, right? Var. But yes, it is absolutely a valid statement. So, 1990. This is 2090. So, I went back in time again. Marvel again. Alita. Star Wars. And Java 12 and 13 came out. Again, not a lot of new visible features, but a lot of preview features were in there. And this, again, most of these visible features were performance. New architecture, the AAR64 architecture became very popular for the M1 and all that. And so lots of stuff happened there. 2020, almost there. Tenet, yeah, I was tired the first time I won. That's not advisable when watching this movie. I didn't get it at all, so I watched it again when I was a bit more awake, and I loved it. But still, at the end of the movie, did I really get this? But yeah, so Traveling in Time, Ultimate Version. Let's do that. Let's go back to the beginning. But it's also the year that Java became 25. Java 14 and 15 came out, and Java 14 had helpful null pointer exception messages. Bit late, but very helpful. But it's really helpful now. So, and in 14, it was still you still had to activate it through a JVM parameter, and in 15, it became standard. And well, create a null pointer exception, and you'll actually... Oh, I have an example. You'll actually get that it is the first element of an array that is null. So, and if you have a train wreck like get this, get that, get sus, and somewhere in that chain a null pointer happens. Well, I don't know about you, but it's debugging hell. Well, it isn't anymore. So, for me, nobody likes null pointers, but we do get them, right? So, good stuff. The switch expression. Quite a bit more nice, right, than forgetting the break. Maybe next time I should put them like the old version and the new version. The old version still works. And now we have the arrow notation. I like it. It's cool. It's new. Let's use it. And text blocks. Well, I'm also a Python fan. Who also does Python? Or, yeah. Since when was it in that language? Since forever, exactly. But still, it's nice to have. I hated that above notation so much that I always wrote a small function to read a file into a variable. Because, damn. Try to maintain this in a unit test. Multi-line strings or text blocks. So, we are almost there, 2021. Free Guy, who watched it? Oh man, I loved Sola. I loved that movie. Yeah. And Dune, I saw the original version from 1986, and I thought that one was fantastic. But I was 12 at the time or something. I rewatched it before going to this movie. I shouldn't have done that. Because my recollection was way different. Yeah. I don't understand this one at all, but it was a box office success. Java 16 migrated to GitHub from, who knows, Mercurial. Yeah. And a period of day was introduced in Java 16. So you can now ask what period of day it is. And it says, in the afternoon. Pattern matching on instance of. This is nice stuff because you have the instance of, and if it is the instance of, it will be assigned to S, and you can immediately start using it. That's nice, right? Almost done. Thank you. Yeah, so use it. Records. Immutability or shallowly immutable? Records are the movement for immutability, right? It started quite a few versions ago with the immutable lists and all that stuff, and trying to get the Java bean completely from the beginning, the getters and setters to be removed. This is finally a record with only getters. But it doesn't necessarily mean that it is completely immutable, because if you have an item in person that is still an old Java bean, that one is still mutable. But hey, very nice, and immutability has proven itself a bit in other languages, so let's get on the train. This one is used so much that they made a convenience method for it. I like it. I have to get used to it, but read, write, string, convenience methods for writing text files. And jpackage. This is one of those things that I want to play with. I have created this example just for this presentation, but I haven't done nothing else with it. But you can actually, this is done on a Mac, and I have a DMG. I don't know if there are many Mac users here, but that's the packaging version for Mac, like MSI for Windows. And with jpackage, you can create these and sign them and do all kinds of cool stuff with them. And so my first version was actually system out print line hello world. Didn't do anything for me. There was no visible thing, so I had to create a swing thing. And swing with method reference. So we can make it cooler than a runnable in there. This is a thing that I would like to do in a meetup or some play around with this kind of stuff. Sealed classes. So now you can actually say, no, a rubber duck cannot extend duck. You'll get an error, or tomato in this case. The enhanced pseudo-random generator was introduced. It's a better random generator. And this is an LTS version. So if you look at this, it is actually the LTS version after 11, right? It's not a really big thing, because we have all these half-yearly versions that already introduced all these nice new features, either in preview or for reals like. So this random generator, so this LTS thing, what does it mean? Maybe I'll write an article about it because I just don't know. But for companies, again, it's important. Java 17. So what's next? Do we get a new avatar? Right after the release of Java 17, Mark Reynolds, the chief architect of Oracle for Java, has pronounced that it will increase the LTS releases. So not every 3 years, but every 2 years. So every 4 versions. And in his article, he actually said, yeah, because companies make it so important, and so we'll just increase the frequency of the LTS versions. Hey, it isn't a good reason, maybe. But for me, actually, I do like it because I would like to move to the newer versions more quickly. Because there's cool stuff in there. So maybe it works. Maybe they have alternative reasons. I don't know. Some useful links. I have made demo code for all of this stuff. So please read the README, because if you open that project in IntelliJ, you will see only errors, because they are all for different versions. The Java Magazine articles about all the other Java versions you can find here. My blog, if you want to know more about me, and the GitHub repository where you find all those other pieces of code. I would like to thank you for attending, because you were awesome. And this was my talk.